Assalamu alaikum. Today, let me briefly show how this small yet powerful Surah As-Shams demonstrate the balance that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created outside of us in this world that we can see and also inside of us in our inner world that we can only feel and contemplate. The Surah can be broken into three parts. The first part illustrates a few magnificent creations of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala which are opposite to each other, yet He subhanahu wa ta'ala balanced them, setting up some limits and boundaries upon them. This primarily deals with the visible world that we can see and experience. The second part, which is the central part of the surah, deals with the metaphysical substance inside us which is known as the Nafs. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala illustrates how a similar kind of balance is created within us just like the outside world. The third part tells about the story of Thamud, how they were warned before they did the evil act and Allah destroyed them to create the balance again. Finally, Allah ends mentioning a wonderful phrase illustrating how He is in complete control of all the affairs of this world, its future and all the consequences that arise out of anyone's action. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala starts by swearing upon the sun and the moon, then the day and the night, finally the sky and the earth. Please note that all of these things are generally speaking opposite items and yet complementing each other, maintaining the perfect harmony in this world. Right after mentioning this, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala moves our focus from the outside world to our inside world, mentioning about the entity known as the Nafs, which He also balanced like the creations of outside world. The word sawah literally means to adjust or make balance of something. The next ayat mentions how Allah creates a balance within the Nafs as it tries to fujur or transgress. We don't need to be much technical to understand fujur, as we understand fajr time, right? When the light of the sun breaks through the darkness of the night. It's like the evil feelings influence us in a way that it wants to come out in action. But on the other side, taqwa of Allah, which refers to the conscience of Allah, keeps us in check and stops us from doing that bad deed. It's like you are in a driving seat with your eyes blocked. You want to press the accelerator in full speed and suddenly, with taqwa, you have made a hard brake to make a complete stop. The next two ayats mentions that our inner part gets polluted continuously, so it's our job to keep on cleaning it and purify it. We should never grow any feelings of self-righteousness as this is a continuous process. The ayats mention that whoever can purify their inner feelings are successful, and failing to maintain it will make us loser. The third part deals with Thamud. They became rebellious on one side, and their prophet warned them not to do something wrong and do no harm to the she-camel. But at last, they couldn't control their nafs of evil feeling and end up doing the grievous crime of killing that she-camel. As the evil went up and created a serious imbalance, so Allah did the fadamdama or the destruction to level it up again to create the balance and maintain the good against the evil. This illustrates a natural phenomena why azab of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala falls upon the humankind as a result of their extreme transgression in a collective form to strike down the balance and to recreate the perfect equilibrium. Finally, Allah brought a conclusion to the surah by mentioning that He doesn't fear of any consequence. The people of Thamud thought that if they would kill the she-camel, the miracle of Allah will no longer be there to attract more people to Islam and they will succeed. But Allah mentions that He is in complete control of the future. He knows what is going to happen from the very beginning and He knows how He will rebalance all the situation either in this world or the next, as He is Al-Hakam, means the ultimate judge or the giver of the ultimate justice. Thank you. Hope you like this video. If you like this video, please don't forget to share this video and hit up that thumbs up button and subscribe to this channel. Thanks.